yesterday afternoon. Nick Maxwell, the skipper of the Pies, and well, he's been terrific to Channel 7 this year. And I'm going to introduce Nick Maxwell, I reckon, probably for the first time. No longer is he the Collingwood skipper. He is the Collingwood Premiership captain. Nick Maxwell, thanks for joining us on game day. Well done yesterday.
Thanks, guys. Thanks a lot.
Now, Maxi, I assume you've thought about this for a long time. Every weight, every run, everything you've ever done is to get where you are now. Does it feel as you hoped it would feel to be a premiership player?
It does, mate. It's just been amazing. And it's, I suppose, a bit of a whirlwind. You still don't really know and believe what's happened. And last night, a couple of us were saying to each other, is this real? And we're going to wake up. What's going on here? So it's just been amazing and something that we'll cherish forever.
Maxi, Tom Harley here. Congratulations.
Hey, Tommy.
How did you go? Did you take the cup home with you? What's been your movements sort of as you left the rooms, I guess?
Yeah, we went back out, just a 22 out in the ground, and just had a bit of a chat amongst us, which was probably the most special moment that I've had with it all, just everyone speaking about it and what it all meant to them. From there, we took the bus back to Amy Park. We're at Amy Park, saw all the fans there, which was amazing. There was over 50,000 fans there and they were in full voice. And from there over to Exhibition Centre, Convention Centre, and we had our function last night. And then after that, a few after parties, which a couple of the boys are still getting home from.
Nick, the moment when you accept victory in your own mind, when was that for you in the game?
11-minute mark of the last quarter, Lee.
Yeah.
I just knew we had it with someone who kicked a goal, and I looked at Nathan Brown, and we just winked at each other, a big smile, and we just knew we had it.
Yeah.
We're just watching images of you directing traffic, just yelling at your teammates, and now going to the knees as the siren sounded. Is that, I mean, that is something you'd love to bottle. But we talked about just before the moment when you went out with the 22 onto the ground. We've got some images of that. You singing the song. Lee talked about it earlier. Did you speak individually? Everyone just had something to say?
Yeah, just individually we all spoke. And I heard you talk about Luke Ball before, and that was probably one of the real special ones, I reckon. He just said, how we'd accepted him and how tough it had been for him. His career was probably on a bit of a downward spiral until he came to Collingwood and got another chance. And he's been an inspiration for our young players. He's been a great leader and a great support for me as captain. And I just couldn't speak highly enough of him.
Nick, you've spoken a long time. Congratulations, Robbo here, mate. You've spoken a lot about your teammates and what about yourself? You know, you spoke earlier this month about the hurdles and your parents and family in the rooms last night. What did it mean to you?
Robbo, just great pride, mate. I said last night at the function that just to wear this jumper week in, week out just means the world to me. And to be able to run out there with 21 guys and achieve what we have. And so I shouldn't say 21 guys. I should say that the 48 guys who have played this year have been part of our list, because there's some real hard luck stories there and real heartbreakers, the guys who have missed out on playing. But they're just as important as anyone.
Right, enough about yourself. You're talking about yourself too much. Nathan Brown, my friend, you stood really close to him yesterday. He played on Nick Riewoldt. Fantastic two grand finals for the young man.
Mate, he was amazing. And I think that for me, the story of the 2010 Collingwood Premiership is probably going to be last week's draw. I think that St Kilda outplayed us in the end and we were lucky to get away with the draw. And Nathan Brown and Dale Thomas were probably two of the guys who are the heroes of that week. And I think that they're the ones who should be remembered for that.
Maxi, talking about Dale Thomas, I follow him on Twitter, and he was pretty busy throughout the night. How's he holding up at the moment?
Mate, he is in all sorts. he walked into the club and literally ran through a boom gate, took it straight off. So he's got his little sidekicks, steel side bottom. The two of them have just been absolute menaces. And I think we're just going to get a couple of security guards just for those two guys.
It's like Cheech and Chong.
Max, with the benefit of hindsight, like the second grand final in consecutive weeks, obviously, just the physical and mental toll. Tell us about
Lee, that last week I was lying to the boys and lying to the media and trying to put out a different vibe. But for 72 hours, I was so shot. I was mentally and physically just exhausted. And I'd go home and I was wrecked. I went to the beach twice each day just to try and get my body going again. And late at night, and I was absolutely shot. But obviously, as you know, mate, as a leader, you got to try and take away your feelings and put forward the ones we really need to. And I think that started on Sunday morning. And just all credit to our guys. I mean, it's a young group. A lot of them could have been down. And I think the major thing we did was we said to them, look, a lot of people don't get the opportunity to play in another grand final. If you've had a poor performance, you don't get to back that up. And our guys got to make amends a week later, and I think most of them did.
Maxie, you're just talking about leaders there. Just very quickly, Mick Malthouse, third premiership. Can you talk about your relationship with Mick and of course, the president, Eddie Maguire, who was in tears in the grandstand last night, and I saw him last night. He was again crying in the rooms. Can you just tell us about the importance of those two men?
Yeah, obviously, Eddie, I mean, a lot of people out there want to bag him, but everyone would love him at their footy club because he's so passionate and he just does everything he possibly can to get the best for the Collingwood Footy Club. And there's also a lot of clubs out there he's done a lot of work for as well, opposition clubs that people don't really appreciate. So he's been amazing. And I guess for me and Mick, early on, my first year, when I didn't know if I was going to get delisted after my first year as a rookie, he said, we're going to give you one more year and give you another chance. And he said to me, I'm going to be extremely hard on you. And from there, I went through 3 or 4 years of, I suppose, copping it from him a fair bit because he knew that I could take it, knew it was going to make me a better player and a better person. And I guess our relationship the last 2 years has just been sensational where I've been able to talk to him about anything to do with the team. And Friday, before the grand final, I said, listen, mate, there's something I want to do with the kickouts, and just started talking him through it. He cut me off halfway through and said, mate, you do whatever you want to do. I trust you 100%. And for me, that was just an amazing moment to have that from him.
And then just the last one, the other big name at Collingwood's obviously Nathan Buckley. Have you spent some one-on-one time with him since the Premiership?
Yeah, we have. We've had a good chat, and I want to make sure that we get Bucks one of these as well, because obviously he fought so hard for so long to get one as a player. And we want to make sure that, obviously, he gets one in the next few years as coach.
Maxie, we're going to let you go. Thank you for all your efforts with Channel 7 this year. You've been wonderful, and congratulations. A big moment for you and the club yesterday.
Thanks, guys.
Nick Maxwell, he is the Premiership captain of the Collingwood Football Club. He's been wonderful to us this year, and he got a couple of hours sleep, and that's about it.